sheets. That hair just keeps getting longer, and I love it. Looking good, pal. Looking real good. Don't ever change. Don't cut it. Let's do this. Hey, good morning, everybody. Happy Friday. We are so excited to be here with you today. Some quick announcements. Next Friday is the last day of community care. While we are sad that community care is ending, fear not. We will be back together on April 12th for in-person instruction. I'm assuming that everybody that's going to community care is doing in-person instruction. So we'll see you then. 1 p.m. dismissals every day the week of March 22nd so that we can have some extra time to get classrooms in order and together. But don't worry. That doesn't mean there isn't learning to do after 1 p.m. There will be asynchronous activities that week that will be assigned for you to complete after 1 o'clock. I'm sure they'll be fun and meaningful. Here we go. After that, dine and donate at Brazilian Bowl on Wednesday, March 24th. Haven't eaten at Brazilian Bowl yet, Mr. Sloan, but real excited to try it. Sounds delicious. You know, I'm a big fan of a bowl. Chipotle, regular. All right, let's get into it. Everybody, oh wait, we have a new game.
Miss Zagleski's new game.
Mystery pictures. So let's take a second look at this mystery picture. It's an extreme close-up of something. What could it be? Make your guesses. This looks like, to me, it looks like a microscopic noodle. Yep, that's what I'm going with. I don't know what it is. Make your guesses in the chat and we will reveal what the mystery picture is in after a couple of Pumas of the week. Here we go, off on our first one. Out of the gate from Miss Drury's class. This Puma's done a wonderful job as a Zoomie. We can always count on her to participate in our lessons and activities. We appreciate all the hard work she's done this year. Keep up the great work. Coming out of Miss Drury's kindergarten class, the Puma of the week is Jordan D. Woo! Way to go, Jordan!
It's coming, it's coming.
I've been there.
Who let your dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
When the party was nice, the party was a clap. And everybody, it's Feinberg. All right. On to the next one. Here we go. From Miss Kamen's class, this front tooth missing Puma continues to regularly participate in class, is becoming a stronger reader and writer every day, and friends love playing with you in breakout rooms. Puma of the week number two, way to go. Coming out of Miss Kamen's class and our kindergarten community, the Puma of the week is Kimball and That was a strange one. Here we go. All right. This thoughtful Puma, the song, obviously, not the Puma of the week. Kimball, love you. All right. This thoughtful Puma continues to impress. She shows responsibility and integrity every day and has been giving her friends helpful reminders of what a strong listener looks like. We are so lucky to have this Puma in our community. Coming out of Ms. Cobiella's room, our Puma of the week is Zeesley M. Let's see what our guesses are. Let's see. 2000s. Oh, boy, who let the dogs out? It's from the 2000s? I had no idea. Let's see. A dog year, second grade guesses. Dog, kindergarten guesses. A duck, a dog, a seahorse, a hat. A soft, velvety, floppy dog year? Could be. A lot of animal guesses, multiple guesses for dog, duck, or bird. Fourth grade guess, duck, pig, dog, ear, hand. Looks like Mr. Malone's classes settled on dog ear. And first grade said a duck. Oh, wait, there's more. Or dog's tail. Puppy or puppy ear. Dobby, Harry, ooh, I like friends. Or a mole. My personal favorite guess is mole. Just going to throw that out there. I love the idea that it's a mole. Let's see what it is, though. What is... Oh! You're right. It's a soft, fluffy puppy ear. Velvety, Miss Mobley. You nailed it. It's like a little golden retriever. So cute. So cute. All right, mystery picture number two. What could it be? Got some stars in there. Maybe the... Well, I'm not going to guess. Don't want to ruin it. I'm so good at guessing these. Definitely not. Okay, here we go. On to the next one. Miss Aglesky and Miss Eden, Spoon of the Week. This Spoon has been working hard all week. He did a great job on his math test, and he's been growing in his reading and writing skills. He also likes to tell the funniest jokes to his classmates. Keep up the great work. Coming out of Miss Aglesky and Miss Eden's first grade community, the Puma of the Week is Nicholas V.
Nice job, Nicholas.
Nice work, Nicholas. Hot jam, Miss Feinberg. Way to go. Lady Gaga's first hit, Poker Face. Pretty good. Or was Let's Dance first? Was Let's Dance first?
Yeah, Just Dance was first.
Okay. Maybe I just like Poker Face more. I don't know. Hey, what are you going to do? You know, everybody's got opinions. All right. On to the next Boom of the Week from Miss Geckle's class. This Puma has been working so hard all year. She always completes her work and shares with her class. Her teacher wants to thank her for the sweet letter she wrote this week. Aw, keep working hard. We love you. Coming out of Miss Geckle's class, the Puma of the Week is Leilani T. Is that Rylan dancing? Who's dancing in Miss Aglesky's class? They are tearing it up. I love it. All right, here we go from Miss Guyon and Mr. Staten's class. This Puma truly shows kindness to everyone they meet. We love that you're in community care every day, ready to learn. Thank you for sharing your smart ideas in reading and math this week. We love you. Coming out of Miss Guyon and Mr. Staten's second grade community, the Puma of the Week is Michaela A. All right. Up next, we got Mr. Sheets's Puma of the Week. This Puma is as kind as they come. He's one of our most positive students who's always looking to uplift his classmates. He's also a true math star and continues to amaze with his math skills. Thanks for being you. Coming out of Mr. Sheets' second grade community, the Puma of the Week is Aiden.
She had me feeling like she's ready to blow.
just watching Ryland like kick those moves, man. Hot moves, Ryland. Way to go. And Mr. Sheets, when's your hair going to get Puma of the Week, huh? Come on. Come on. All right. Here's the reveal. Let's see what people guessed. A lot of cupcake guesses is what I saw. Cookie and Rainbow Volcano could be my favorite guess so far. Paint set. Others think cupcake, cake, ice cream, toy, jello, yogurt. Lots of covering the gambit there. Cake with rainbow star sprinkles. Camila says ice cream. Miss Feinberg guessed cupcake. Miss Mobley guessed candy. Noah V from Miss Cullen Revels class guessed mole again. I love it. Doubtful. Also, no, I'm kidding. That was from the last one. All right. Soccer ball could be a good guess. Let's see. Danny, shout out. Hot jams today, huh? You know all of them. Great. Cupcake and ice cream, 214. Play-doh, jello, eggs, and lamp. Ooh, could be an Easter egg, right? Who knows? Mr. Sheets guessed cupcake. All right, Miss Gecko guessed cake. Let's see what the answer or what the real photo is of. Woo! It's a banana split. A banana split. Ooh, lots of, they are star sprinkles. You're right about that. But that red part's a cherry. Yum, yum, yum. Okay. Here we go. Mystery picture number three. Take a gander. Look at it. What is it? Let's see. Looks like some sort of plumbing. That's what I'm going with. Some sort of plumbing device tool. Seems like, yep. All right. Coming out of Miss Cullen Revels class this week. Every single student has improved in one way or another. There is more participation and effort than ever before, especially in writing. Students who used to only write a couple sentences are now writing wonderful storybooks with chapters. Woo! This teacher is so proud of each and every one of you. This week's Puma of the Week coming out of Miss Cullen Revels class is the entire class. Woo!
Hey guys,
way to go!
So proud.
It's fine. Nice work, Miss Cullen Revels class. Okay, on to the next one from Miss Lebowski Wong's class. We are so lucky to have this student in our community. His classmates nominated him for showing drive, working hard each day, and being kind and helpful toward others. Thank you for being you. Coming out of Miss Lebowski Wong's third grade community, the Puma of the Week is William O. You think you got it all, you think you got it, but got it, just don't get it, cause there's nothing at all. All right, here we go. On to Miss Myers Puma of the Week from our fourth grade community. Wow. We have been blown away by this Puma's participation, focus, and engagement in her learning this week. She made incredible predictions and inferences in reading class, advocated for herself by asking questions, and participated both in the chat and by coming off mute. What an amazing week from Miss Myers. Fourth grade community, the Puma of the Week is Abigail A. Woo! Here we go, Abby. All right, here we go. Our final Puma of the Week from Mr. Malone's class. This week's Puma was nominated by his classmates for showing pride. They noticed his hard work and focus that he takes his time to do well on assignments. A couple of students were impressed by how he participates during class, even when he was new to the school. That takes courage and confidence. We are so glad you joined our class. Coming out of Mr. Malone's fourth grade community, the Puma of the Week is Julian Nah. Hot jam. What was that? Is that Katy Perry? Is that right?
Sure is.
I know it. I'm there. Okay, let's see what folks thought. Obviously, this is a piece of plumbing, some way, shape, or form. There's definitely liquids flowing through it. Let's see. Not many people agree with me. Most people are guessing roller coaster. Put your hands up on the way down. That's what Miss Mobley says. Woohoo! Let's see. Oh, a rail and bridge. Could be. That's basically everybody thinks it's a roller coaster. Mr. Malone thinks it's from a playground. JDL says a bridge. Anelli says a water park. Let's see what the reveal is. Woo, here it comes. It's a roller coaster. Not plumbing. Definitely not plumbing. All right. I'm assuming that this is our final mystery picture. What could it be? Take a gander. Think about it. Use that brain. Get it warmed up. Start making connections. See those synapses firing? There's electrical activity happening in there. It's what makes it all go around. All right, here we go. It's time for our enrichment stars of the week. First out of the gate, as always, is our art star. This puma has been a great example of creativity and focused. She's used her knowledge of all elements of art to create an impressive masterpiece. Great work. Coming out of Miss Guyon's class, the art star of the week is Jenna R.
Yay, Jenna.
Good job, Jenna.
Woohoo! All right, here we go. This puma did a great job with our challenges this week by exploring her curiosity through material use and new designs. She did a great job of sharing her ideas as well. Our makerspace star of the week coming out of Miss Igleski's class is Madeline P.
Woo! Ooh, nice job, Maddie.
Hot jam, by the way, real hot. Here we go. This puma is always the first to offer his help to classmates with any problem, even if it isn't music related. Mr. C loves his caring and helpful attitude. He's a natural leader. Coming out of Miss Geckel's class, the music star of the week, Jordan C. All right, on to our final enrichment star of the week. This puma is a very hard worker and had outstanding participation this week in PE. He takes initiative in class and is an awesome role model. Way to go. Coming out of Miss Kamen's class, the puma of the week is, or the PE star of the week, excuse me, Aizen R. Way to go, Aizen.
Woo. Way to go, Aizen.
All right. It's time for our big reveal. See what the guesses say. Let's see. Francisco from Miss Guyon's class thinks it's a bunny headband. Let's see. A lot of Mickey Mouse guesses. Mickey or Minnie Mouse. That seems to be the consensus. Let's see the big reveal. Here we go. Yeah, it's Mickey Mouse. Ah, there he is. Your old pal, Mickey Mouse. Right, Mr. Sloan? All right. Oh, the staff of the week. Here we go. Oh, look at this.
Wait a second. We do have a riddle today. Riddle me this, ladies and gentlemen. Who is a hawk-watching, chipotle-walking, sweater-wearing, riddle-reading, large-group-sharing, fantastic leader who takes the time to listen to every staff member, student, and parent and show incredible empathy in every situation? Who has been leading staff through the toughest time in America for a year with strength and grace and always making sure that we are laughing? Who is an incredible, who has incredible Puma pride that is nothing to shake a stick at? Drop those guesses in the chat. Oh, wait. We already know it. We already love it. The Puma of the week is Mr. Keebler.
Woo! Yeah! Woo! Oh, man. Thanks, everybody. Campbell, it's the family suite. Family suite. Here we go. Thanks, Mr. Sloan. Thanks, everyone. Very kind words. Very kind words. It's easy to do it with a community like we have. I'll say that. Easy may be an overstatement, but it makes it a lot better to do it with people like this. Thanks, everyone, for your energy, your enthusiasm, your engagement today. We are so happy to be doing this with you. Please remember, work hard, do your best today and every day. And as always, if you're proud to be a Puma, let me hear you say, Puma Pride! Have a fantastic day, everyone.